Fuels are the substance that provide energy on combustion. Liquid fuels. Liquid fuels have many advantages over solid fuels. They have higher calorific value. They burns with less smoke, free from ash. They require less air for combustion. The process of combustion is controlled. Storage and handling of liquid fuels is easy. Thermal efficiency is also higher. They are easy to transport through pipes. But due to their high volatility and inflammability, they have higher fire hazards. The main source of liquid fuel is petroleum. Petroleum is the crude oil that is obtained from Earth's surface. It is the fossil fuel that is created by decomposition of organic matter over millions of years. The crude petroleum is a mixture of various hydrocarbons, mainly paraffins, cycloalkanes, aromatic hydrocarbons, compounds containing sulfur, nitrogen, oxygen, benzene, toluene, etc. The average composition of petroleum is carbon 93% to 97%, hydrogen 10% to 14%, nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur with some trace metals. The petroleum is obtained by mining from underground reservoirs. The crude petrol obtained have many impurities. It needs refining. The solid impurities are removed by washing. The water, brine, is removed by Cottrell's process. Sulfur impurities are also removed by treating with copper oxide. Substances like sodium chloride, magnesium chloride are removed by electrical desalting and dehydration. The crude oil is then sent to fractional distillation to obtain various fractions of petroleum. It is first heated to a temperature of about 400 degrees Celsius. The oil vapors are then sent to fractionating column. In fractionating column, the oil vapors rises up, they become cool and condense. The compounds having higher boiling points are condensed at lower part of column, while the low boiling fractions are condensed at top of the tower. From the figure given, we can see that at 340 degrees Celsius, heavy oil is obtained. Then at 260 degrees Celsius, diesel oil. At 180 degrees Celsius, kerosene. At 110 degrees Celsius, naphthalene. At 40 degrees Celsius, petrol. Above it, at 30 degrees Celsius, petroleum ether is obtained. And below 30 degrees Celsius, uncondensed gases are obtained. The uncondensed gases can be used as liquefied petroleum gas. Petroleum ether is used as solvent and in dry cleaning. Petrol is used as automobile fuel, naphthalene as solvent, kerosene as domestic fuel, jet fuel and illuminant, diesel as diesel engine fuel. Heavy oil is further vacuum distillated to obtain lubricating oil, vaseline, grease and paraffin wax. The solid residue contain asphalt and petroleum coke. The petrol obtained from fractional distillation is just the 40% of total demand of petrol. So we need further methods to obtain petrol. These methods include cracking of heavy oil and to obtain synthetic petrol. Now the first method, cracking. Cracking is decomposition of higher molecular weight hydrocarbons into smaller molecules. Generally, heavy oil is cracked to obtain gasoline. Cracking is of two types, thermal cracking and catalytic cracking. Thermal cracking, when cracking is carried out at higher temperature, then it is thermal cracking. It is further is of two types, liquid phase thermal cracking, vapor phase thermal cracking. Heavy oil is cracked through liquid phase thermal cracking. In this process, oil is heated to a temperature of about 475 to 530 degrees Celsius with at a pressure of 100 kg per centimeter square. The yield of petrol by this method is 60%. The volatile liquid fuels like kerosene is cracked through vapor phase thermal cracking. In this method, the oil is heated to a temperature of about 600 to 650 degrees Celsius at a low pressure of 10 to 20 kg per centimeter square. The yield of gasoline is 50 to 60%. The second method of cracking is catalytic cracking. When the process of cracking is carried out in presence of catalyst, it is catalytic cracking. Further catalytic cracking can be carried out by two methods, fixed bed type or moving bed pipe. Now the first method, fixed bed catalytic cracking. In this method, the catalyst, that is artificial clay mixed with zirconium oxide, is used. It is fixed in catalyst tower. The heavy oil is preheated to a temperature of about 425 to 450 degrees Celsius and then it is sent to catalyst chamber. Catalyst chamber is maintained at a temperature of 425 to 450 degrees Celsius with a pressure of about 1.5 kg per centimeter square. Cracking occurs at this place. The carbon formed is adsorbed on catalyst bed. The catalyst bed, when exhausted due to deposition of carbon, is reactivated by burning of the carbon. The vapors produced on cracking, that is cracked vapors, are further passed into fractionating column where the heavy oil is condensed and removed. The gasoline vapors are sent to condenser, then to stabilizer where dissolved gases are removed and gasoline is recovered. The gasoline obtained by this method have higher anti-knocking properties. The second method of catalytic cracking is moving bed catalytic cracking. In this method, solid catalyst is powdered and mixed with heavy oil. The oil vapors and powdered catalyst are then sent to a reactor where temperature of about 500 degrees Celsius is maintained. Cracking occurs here. The carbon gets deposited over catalyst particles. They become heavy and settles down. Spent catalyst is sent to catalyst regenerator using air blower, whereas cracked vapors are sent to fractionating column where heavy oil is removed and the gasoline vapors are further sent to condenser and stabilizer where gasoline is recovered and uncondensed gases are removed. In catalyst regenerator, the deposited carbon is burnt and catalyst is retained. The retained catalyst is then mixed with fresh incoming oil vapors. This method uses catalyst in economic manner. The yield of petrol is good. Also, it has higher anti-knocking properties. The next method to obtain petrol is synthetic petrol. When petrol is derived from non-petroleum product, the type of petrol is known as synthetic petrol. There are two methods to obtain synthetic petrol: Fischer-Tropsch method and Burgess method. Fischer-Tropsch method. In Fischer-Tropsch method,
catalytic reduction of carbon monoxide and hydrogen is carried out to obtain a mixture of straight chain alkane and olefins. At first, mixture of water gas, that is carbon monoxide and hydrogen, with excess hydrogen is passed through a purification chamber. The mixture of iron oxide and iron oxide and sodium carbonate are used to remove sulfur and sulfur compounds. The gaseous mixture is then sent to catalyst chamber. The catalyst is a mixture of cobalt 100 parts, thoria 5 parts, magnesia 8 parts and kiselguhar 200 parts. A temperature of about 200 to 250 degrees Celsius is maintained. The gaseous mixture gets converted into a mixture of saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons with the release of huge amount of heat. The products are then cooled. The gasoline is recovered. The heavy oil obtained is further cracked into gasoline. The second method of preparing synthetic petrol is Burgess method. This process is used to convert low-grade coals such as bituminous coal into liquid and gaseous fuel by hydrogenating them in presence of catalyst, that is nickel or tin oleate. In this process, at first, powdered coal is mixed with heavy oil and catalyst. It is then heated with hydrogen for about 1.5 hours to a temperature of about 450 degrees Celsius and a pressure of about 250 atm in a converter. The gases are then fed to condenser where crude oil is obtained. This crude oil is fractionated to get gasoline, middle oil and heavy oil. The heavy oil obtained is recycled to form the paste. Middle oil is cracked to get more gasoline and gasoline is then recovered. So by using these methods, petrol can be obtained. Thanks.